I'm Sigrid, and you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I am Zach Monson here with Stingray PausePlay at Osheaga 2019 with a very special episode here with Sigrid. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good. What is your fondest childhood musical memory?
Oh, wow. This is really cheesy, but
usually these answers are pretty cheesy. Yeah,
it's the question. It leads up to something cheesy. So it's probably my whole family is very into music. I'm the only one who does it like full time. My brother does music too.
Yeah.
He just released a single, which is very exciting. But awesome. He studies too. But anyways, my fondest childhood memory of music is probably playing music back home with them, listening to music with them in the living room, singing together.
Were there certain
really
songs that you
cringe.
Love to sing together as a family?
Yeah. Neil Young, Give Me Strength.
Oh, amazing.
That's the big one in
that's
our family.
That's
the one. And we even did a Neil Young cover concert.
No.
Seriously. Yes. Yeah. So we were, the whole family, we've seen him 6 times together. Yes. We're a big
that's
family.
That's really cute.
He was playing in Bergen.
Okay.
And we were invited to do like a family concert at a bar before the show.
Wow.
So we played all our favorite Neil Young songs. It was really nice.
So you guys all went as a family.
Yes.
How many songs did you guys do?
I think it was like a half an hour or something.
Oh my gosh. Is there
really
like a
nice.
Video of this somewhere?
I think so, yeah.
Oh,
should
I'm
probably
gonna
find it.
Yes, you should definitely find it and send it to me so I can cut it into this interview. Where you're from, Olsen, which is so
nice pronunciation.
Thank you so much. I've been trying that one too. So beautiful, so picturesque and lovely.
Thank you.
Are there certain things that you have to do or foods you have to eat when you go back home, other than seeing your family?
Thank you for asking me this. I love talking about Olsen. You have to eat fish.
Okay.
It's a fishing town.
Okay. Have
so
to, yeah.
Great fresh fish that you can buy from the harbor every day.
Yeah.
And then you have to go to Sukkertoppen, which is like a really cozy, nice 45-minute hike. Really easy, but a lovely view of the city.
Awesome.
What else do you have to do? You have to go to the studio on Giske, Ocean Sound Recordings. That's an island right outside my city.
Okay.
Where I recorded my album.
And how often do you get to be home for anything more than like 2 days?
Not that often.
No.
I sometimes go there for work, ironically, but maybe because I talk so much about my own dominant work that like people want to hear more about it.
Yeah.
So that's nice. I love combining those two. But my family comes visiting me more. Yeah.
Okay, good. And you, I mean, you say your English is not very good. Your English is fantastic. You've been learning English since you were, 7?
Yeah, that's when you started in Norway.
Do you have a favorite English word?
Eggy.
What is it?
Eggy. So eggy is a term that I learned from someone in my crew.
Okay.
And it means when someone is acting, this is like apparently a very British thing to say. And it's like when someone is acting a bit like sneaky or you can't really put your finger on it. It's not sleazy.
Okay.
It's but just more kinda like... Yeah.
Like hiding your surprise party from you?
No.
Or more
no,
mean?
It's just when someone is acting like a not shady. It's a between shady and sleazy and sneaky.
Okay.
It's like it's negative.
I like it. I really
eggy.
Like it.
I really like it. It's like when you just know someone's eggy.
We asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question.
Mm.
And the artist is Sam Fender, who is amazing. And his question is,
I'm Sam Fender and my question for you is, have you ever shat yourself or pissed yourself on stage?
Great question. No, I have not.
Good.
Which I'm really happy that I haven't.
I'm very happy for you. What is the worst thing that's ever happened to
you
on stage?
I wonder if he's done it. Since he's asking it.
He
is
might.
This like a question out of experience?
I'll go find. He's. I think he's still
around.
We should
go
find
out.
We'll go
find
him. What is the worst thing that ever happened to you on stage?
I think. Well, there's a few things to take. I remember one time we played a show in Brighton, and we'd made this like really. We thought it was a cool outro of "Don't Kill My Vibe." That was our last song in that set. This was early on, and something got fucked up with the tracks, and I messed up too. So
ready? Hold on. Hey, Sam. Come here for a second.
Hello.
Was it you that you
got
my question?
So the question for you is that have you ever peed your pants on stage?
Oh God, I can't believe I'm saying this. I shit myself on stage once in 2013.
What?
Yeah, it actually happened.
How?
Oh, I was like, I used to be doing this rubbish pub gig. I was playing like in a restaurant.
Are you being stopped
right
now?
And I got press as well. I was really ill and I was working in a call center at the time, and the only thing I could eat, because there was only this one shop that was selling Bombay Bad Boy pot noodles, and I had one of them and I shit myself on stage. It's the worst day of my life.
Good to see you, Sam.
This is the best
quote. Thanks for stopping by, bro. So the answer is yes, he did.
What the hell was that? I cannot believe he just said that, but sure.
So yeah. So moving past, Sucker Punch.
Yeah.
What a wonderful group of songs this is. I really like love it so much. Which was the song that was the easiest to complete from start to finish?
I think actually, I don't know. Yeah, I think it was Sucker Punch.
Oh yeah?
Sucker Punch was pretty immediate. We finished it in like 2 days, and then they just did some add-on production afterwards, but it's pretty...
The song that I have listened to the most is Mine Right Now. Oh. Mine Right Now is one of my favorite songs right now. Oh my God.
Thank you.
So good.
I really appreciate it. We're going to play it later today, so...
It's really, really good. So, how did this whole song come about? Because really, the music video alone, for me, is one of my favorite music videos I've ever seen in my whole life.
To begin with, I cannot believe there's actually a few journalists that have thought it's a PR stunt.
Oh, no.
And when I read it, I just started laughing, but also like, do you really think we would go through all of that? But no, it's real.
I mean, it would be a very good PR stunt if you did.
It would be a good one, but it's 100% real. So what happened was that I was on my way to the shoots, and it was just too many delayed flights and canceled flights. I seriously could not get there physically.
Yeah.
And we had a crew of 40 people waiting for me to arrive and do my part. And it was such a big crew and a lot of money put on it. So we were like... Fuck, we gotta do something. And all of this happened without me. I actually didn't know until I think they'd already started shooting when they called me. So they just thought that, okay, someone needs to step in for Sigrid. So Max did it, the director. He's an absolute legend. It's a brilliant crew. But the craziest thing is that it was crazy enough that I could make it to the shoot and I'm not in the video. But the fact
you
that
you are
they,
in the video, yeah.
Yeah, kind of.
You sing a bit in there.
I know. It was shot in my management's office in Bergen. It was like selfie mode.
Yeah, but I think it's perfect.
But like, there was a serial killer on the loose in the mountains during the shoots.
Oh, good.
Yeah. They had a lot of police cars. Apparently, they were like hikers trying to chase them off the mountains. The drone fell in the water and got ruined. I think they have insurance on that, so that's good. But like, set collapsed. It was just...
Unreal.
It was just a shit show.
I don't see... Because watching the pieces of the video that would have been in the original video, I don't see how the original video could be better than the way it turned out.
No, me neither.
There's no way.
Like, oh, obviously, I hate that this is the outcome of the video,
but I think it's
a great video. It's
fantastic.
It's really funny.
I think
the most important thing for me about the video is that it shows all the hard work that is behind music video shoots and how many people are involved.
100%.
So I guess it's an homage to everyone 100%. Who's had shitty music video
shoots. Yeah. Okay, and if you had to live inside anybody else's music video for the rest of your life, what would it be?
Great question. I love music videos. Okay. Which one? Which one? There's so many. Maybe an Ariana Grande music video. No, wait. Taylor Swift, maybe. The Blank Space music video.
Oh, why that one?
One of my favorites. Or the Thank You Next video, of course. Maybe one of Tame Impala's videos because they're so trippy.
True.
Which one would you live in?
Oh, geez. No one's ever asked me that question before.
Da.
And you know what? I've never even actually thought about it.
No?
There's like that video for Mace and Puff Daddy for Mo Money Mo Problems.
All right.
And it's like they shot it in Vegas and it just looks like such a good time.
Nice.
That I think that's where I would
Sounds
live
good.
To the
yeah,
rest of my life.
Great.
Thank you so much for talking to me. You're
Thank
such
you
a treat, and your music
me.
Is so, so good. I can't wait to see you explode in the next
year. I really appreciate
Truly.
It.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
You can hear Secret music on Stinger Music's Future Pop channel, the Oh My God channel, the Rising Stars channel. If you want to find out all of the 23 channels we play your music on, go on our mobile app or web player, find the search icon, magnifying glass, type in Sigrid, S-I-G-R-I-D, and you'll see them. Thanks so much, guys.